Welcome to the Small Business Voice with Justin Duncan and Jeanette Forney on Power Talk 1360 KFIV and the iHeart app. We are here every Saturday to highlight local entrepreneurs and small business owners and to learn how they succeed to build their businesses from the ground up. What are their challenges and what are their victories? Jeanette, how are you doing this morning?
I'm doing great. I'm sorry I was late.
You scared me this morning. I was very nervous because I couldn't get a hold of you.
Yeah, my phone was dead, and I leave so early in the morning certain times. Like, I'm up like 3 o'clock in the morning, grab the phone. I think that probably didn't charge overnight.
Yeah.
And then I gave myself plenty of time to get to a studio today, and they had some lanes closed, and one of my pet peeves is people being on time. Time is money.
Yeah.
And if you're late, then you're late to your next appointment. And so I apologize. I'm sure my office manager probably has the whole, army out searching for me. So if we hear a helicopter, that's for me.
Well, I did text Pamela. So
okay, good.
Yeah, so
she worries.
Yeah, I know. Well, we all worry about you. I mean, and it's not that it's because we love you. You're a friend of ours. And we just, when something's not right,
My kids, when they went to St. Anthony's, if a mommy was late, they would always end up saying, "Well, if mommy's late, she's either dead or something's happened."
Yeah.
So it's like I'm known for being. If I say I'm going to be somewhere, I'm going to be there. You don't have to remind me.
Well, your mind starts to wander, okay. Because you're always here on time, like you said, so.
And with busy lives. And I mean, I have such a busy life, so.
Yeah.
But I'm excited. I did not want to miss today or be late because I'm so excited that Stephanie Montalvo is going to be
here
today.
That's right. Today's show, we have Stephanie Montalvo. That's going to be good to kind of see what we're going to do. Like, I took the test.
Leadership. And I'll tell you right now, I have absolutely no idea what your test results are. And I had a new hire yesterday. And I sent over and told her to take the test. I want to kind of like know who have I hired, how to best communicate with her. A lot of companies, corporations also use personality tests to make sure that they have the right person in the right position. And I have known through the years, if you have someone that loves customer service and it's just that customer service person, you can't just all of a sudden tell them to do sales. They're not going to be happy. They're going to quit on you. Mm. And a salesperson might be great at customer service, but it drains them. I mean, it's like telling Mrs. Smith why her bill went up 50 cents. They're not going to sell for the rest of the afternoon. It just... different personality types.
Yeah.
One is not better than the other one, but one might be better for a certain job than another one.
Yeah, it's good to know.
I even gave the test to my daughter. And they're head cheerleader and out there smiling and, really cute and taking charge. I thought that she was going to be more like me. And now I found out that her career choices should be engineer, architect, or accountant. And that is why she's so great at doing my QuickBooks. And she sits there for hours and she gets enjoyment out of getting it down to the last penny. She actually said, what, Mom? I do enjoy task-oriented things where I can start, I can finish, it is perfect. She's going to go to college now and start taking accounting and business courses.
Nice.
Because with her, she also wants that degree that says, I know how to do it.
So I have a Legal Shield story to tell you really quick. So I do Legal Shield on the side. I like to make sure that business owners, especially business owners, have legal protection. And I stayed at a hotel with my son this last weekend. So when you're in Vegas now, you have to pay for parking when you stay at the casinos. It's like San Francisco
Nothing is free.
No,
Vegas is not like San Francisco. I'll go to Vegas. I won't go to San Francisco.
Well, you can't park anywhere for free. Yeah. And Vegas is starting to be the same way. That's the comparison I'm kind of
drawing. That's an Allstate agent. You can't park in San Francisco if you don't want your windows smashed in and the car stolen. Okay, so there we go.
So
go ahead.
Let's
not start comparing.
But anyway, I paid for my parking before I left. And then when I was exiting, you're supposed to scan your ticket. And for some reason, when I got to the gate, it just lifted up and let me out. And it gave me a green light.
Oh, so you went right back to the roulette table? That's lucky.
Yeah, I should have. If they send me a letter, if the casino sends me a letter saying that you didn't pay for parking, I know I got Legal Shield as a backup where they can fire something back, saying, hey, look, here's this receipt, here's this, because when you don't pay for parking, you probably get fines that go on top of that, and a 24 dollar parking ticket now is like $200.
That's like when I go on road trips and then I get a letter that it was some toll road.
Yeah. So you're listening to the Small Business Voice with Jess Dungan and Jeanette Forney on Power Talk 1360 KFIV. We're here with Stephanie Montalvo today. She'll be here pretty soon because she's going to give us the lowdown on
personality type. Like, so I'm so excited to find out if I finally hired like a salesperson, because we need sales, and to find out your results, who you are, and you know, and hopefully first you'll probably explain to us and our audience what the test is, what it measures, and why it's so important. I think I've always used it. I've used some type of personality test in hiring with people that I work with, and it's been basically so I can learn how best to communicate with them. And find out what their personality, what motivates them, how to, not everyone's motivated by money. And so it is interesting to find out that I have the right people in the right job.
Yeah. Well, and that's good. So I'm kind of a one man show, and I'd like to, you know, that's actually good. I mean, it's a,
find out your strengths. I'll find out your strengths. Yeah. And I found out what my weaknesses are.
Yeah.
I know what my strengths are. And that most of us do.
Yeah.
But then when you kind of get it in writing, what you need to work on, then that's something that you kind of, you know, keep in the back of your mind. When things happen in life, you're going, oh, yeah, this is something I have to work on, even at my age.
We're going to bring Stephanie in here pretty soon. And then I think we're going to have her back in because we're going to have her do an assessment on Kurt also.
Ooh. Oh, excellent. Yeah. Excellent, yeah.
And I can see the look on Kurt's face right now. He looks very excited.
Everyone's going to know me. It's going to be like, but yeah, definitely. Yeah. This is going to be fun. Too. This is going to be fun.
Yeah, so really quick, Kurt, you just nod your head. But so this Saturday, I'm thinking later on today, do you think that commercial's going to be ready that you and I did? Okay.
Featuring my truck.
Yeah, featuring Jeanette's truck. So, yeah, I'll just say later on today, yeah, we're going to have this commercial come out on social media. I'm excited about it. I've been waiting. I just been waiting for this to come out because I'm so proud of our work. I'll give you a teaser. There's a certain part of my body that makes a debut on the camera.
Oh, my goodness.
Yeah.
Okay.
But it's clean, so it's not.
Well, I can't wait to see the commercial, because the commercial is something that you're now involved in also with media.
Yeah. Yeah. And I'm excited, and Kurt and I are working out a agreement. Because I was thinking about it the other day, like, you know, he did all the work. I just acted in it. And I like creating and acting, but I didn't do any of the camera work. I didn't do any of the voice stuff. I didn't do anything like that. I just acted in it. But I also got to create it too. Like, I wrote the script, and then Kurt did the storyboard, and
definitely be fun. So
yeah,
our audience out there, I mean, look for it later on this afternoon. Are we going to post anything special on it? Like, if they go on Small Business Voice, will it have a link maybe to the commercial?
Yeah. So I think we're going to put it on Kurt's YouTube, and then we'll put it on my YouTube, and then we'll go ahead and launch it. So you're listening to the Small Business Voice with Jess Dungan and Jeanette Forney on Power Talk 1360 KFIV. Reach out to us for information on any of our featured guests by texting 209-896-6500, or you can always email us at info@smallbusinessvoicemedia.com, and you can pull up any of our past shows on the iHeart app. Just search and follow the Small Business Voice. Like and follow on Facebook, Instagram, X, TikTok, and YouTube. Stephanie Montalvo was here, so we're going to bring her in, so stay with us on Power Talk 1360 KFIV.
Hey girl, what's your name, girl? I've been looking at you, and every guy here's doing the same, girl.
Right now, I really need a beer with my... Welcome back to the Small Business Voice with Justin Duggan and Jeanette Forney on Power Talk 1360 KFIV. Reach out to us for more information on our featured guest by texting 209-896-6500, or you can always email us at info@smallbusinessvoicemedia.com. And you can always pull up any of our past shows on the iHeart app. Just search and follow the Small Business Voice. Like and follow us on Facebook, Instagram, X, TikTok, and YouTube. And today's guest is Stephanie Montalvo.
If you work with people And I even had a personality test done on my daughter. I mean, because, you know, that's mm-hmm. the whole thing. We all, even my daughter that I've lived with for 23 years, I thought of her as this completely outgoing person. And as a mother and a business owner, I was getting frustrated. I was getting frustrated. Well, come on, you're out there cheering in front of all these people. You'd be great in sales. You should be doing this. And there was like this pushback that, you know, she didn't like it. Mm-hmm. And when I got the test back, it came back to some of her best career choices would be architect, mm-hmm. engineer, mm-hmm. accountant.
She was a precisionist.
Mm-hmm. she likes task oriented mm-hmm. and she likes things done correctly.
Yes.
And I'm actually a total opposite of my daughter. If you take her personality and flip it mirror around. Mm-hmm. And so that, now I understand that. I'm never going to push her to go to a live event again mm-hmm. unless she can be in the background to take the photographs. But she did a great job
at the live event.
Yeah,
you know what?
That's what Stephanie also told me. It doesn't mean that someone can't do it. Mm-hmm. It's just what's going to make them happy. And like for men, happy wife, happy life. I think for a business, mm-hmm. happy staff, you know, makes for a happy office.
Oh, that's true.
So I ended up actually hiring Stephanie to do the personality assessments uh-huh. on my staff. And we've been in customer service mode for about a year. And mm-hmm. my staff, they all get along great. They had a paint night. I mean, after work, they put on a video of a Bob Ross and they all painted this painting. Yeah. And then, of course, me, I came in next morning and I'm like, did you guys all watch the same video? Because, I mean, the artistic expression was great. And then I hired someone, a brand new girl, and the first thing I said was, I want you to take this personality test. So today, I'm going to find out if, I have maybe a salesperson. Because mm-hmm. we're back into sales, and Stephanie, she says, yeah, they're all great, and yes, they can do sales. But this is not what their personality was born mm-hmm. to do. So she's going to be working with my team mm-hmm. to get them a little bit better about sales and putting all of their best talents together. Yeah. So yes, I'm very interested.
Yeah.
My new hire. First of all, just tell me, this one is called
DISC. So DISC. There's four primary styles. And it's D-I-S and C. Mm-hmm. And the way that it's kind of, you break it down population-wise, only 3% of the population are personality style D.
3%?
3%.
Oh, I'm special.
Yeah, and I wrote this all down at our at the event mm-hmm. because that's the D stands for more
dominant, more direct.
Yeah,
give me the facts. Then I style personality is more outgoing, more talkative. And there's only about 11% of the population that are I's.
Okay.
And then C, there's about 17% of the population that are C's, and they're more calculated. They like the details, more precise, like your daughter.
Oh, yeah.
And then finally, we have S personality style, which there's about 69% of the population that are S's. And that's more of a steady, more stable personality.
Okay.
They're a little more slow to make decisions. They want some more details.
That's who you want as your accountant.
They're cautious. Yeah. So in your office, when we did the assessments, you know, obviously you're a D, a personality style. Yep, she's a DI. And her staff were mostly C's and S's. We had no I personality styles.
You don't have a single I in your office. And I'm going like, what?
Jeanette has I. She's dominant in I as a leader. Uh-huh. Her office operations person has some I also, but mm-hmm. it's not on the high end. It's on the lower end. So my suggestion to Jeanette was to bring in someone, you know, hire someone with an I style personality because that's what she's lacking.
I wish we could have a drum roll right now. I hired someone yesterday.
Yes.
And they actually saw me at an event, mm-hmm. which was like a week ago. Mm-hmm. And when they saw me speak and they went to someone and said, do you think she would give me a job interview? This person has all of her insurance licenses. And she called me up, says, can I come in and talk to you? And I hired her. And then the second thing that I said, oh my gosh, I'm going to have you take a personality test. And I had her email sent to Stephanie. And Stephanie today, one day later, is going to tell me if I have an I, which is what my office needs for sales. So mm-hmm. I wish we had a drum roll. Does anyone, can you tell me? How's my new hire? Can you please tell me her personality?
Well, congratulations, Jeanette. You made the right decision. You hired a high I personality.
Oh, there you go.
There we go.
She's, she's actually three. She has a combination of three styles. She's an ISC.
So she's going to be influential sales, but still have a heart.
Yep.
And she won't be that reckless salesperson that doesn't deal with compliance.
Right.
Because Allstate is all about doing it correctly. Yep. We write perfect policies. Download everything to protect our clients. So I hire, just like you told me, I have the perfect manager that keeps everything smooth in my office. I now have my go-getter, but friendly, but precise salesperson.
Yes. Congratulations.
Nice.
You're complete.
I'm complete.
Yes.
So now let's make some money and really serve those customers.
Yes. And so one of the things that I do a little bit different, I don't just do an assessment and then you take it, you read it, and you stick it in a drawer somewhere. With the assessment, I include a debrief where I go through the report in detail. It's about a 30-minute debrief as part of the process.
You did that with each one of my staff, and you're going to do that with this new hire, too.
Yes, I will.
Excellent.
And then in addition to that, what I did with your office was I came back with a plan, right?
Yeah, plan.
Some training, some additional services that I can offer to help build on what we learned.
Mm-hmm.
And so we're going to be
I want a good team.
Yep.
I want a team that works together and really, it's tough to hire a new person. It's getting a new person into the family. And you know, you want them all to get along.
Mm-hmm.
And so that's when you're going to come in and do some team building.
Yep.
With my office, and I'm excited. That's what you need.
That's good, because not all families get along.
That's right.
And that's the whole thing. Yeah. I have a business to run, and that's the whole thing. Mm-hmm. I want to be able to concentrate on what's important to me.
Absolutely.
And I'm sorry, paint night is not important to me, but
it was important to them, though, right?
Exactly.
I think that's kind of awesome. I was going
to
say,
I can't wait to hear your personality.
Well, because I like Bob Ross, you know, and I watch documentaries on Bob Ross and Mr. Rogers, because that was like my childhood.
And they were so sweet. They gave me my own paint palette and my own easel and paintbrushes, even though I have a lot of those things. I am creative. Mm-hmm. That's how I relax.
Mm-hmm.
And it's still sitting in my charger. And they keep asking me, going, haven't you done the Bob Ross painting yet?
So I'm going to say you probably need to do that. So you're listening to the Small Business Voice with Josh Duggan and Jeanette Forney on Power Talk 1360 KFIV. And we are here with Stephanie Montalvo. And she works at the John Maxwell Leadership Group, Live to Lead. If you want to get a hold of Stephanie Montalvo, give her a call or text her at 209-986-3121. Or you can also contact her at stephanieleads2@gmail.com. She's here. She's going to give my assessment.
Yeah, I can't wait, because, you know, we work together. And see, that's the whole thing. Different personality types can really, really either, you know, flatter each other, get along great with each other. Mm-hmm. And so I'm kind of glad that she's not a D, because two strong personalities, they have to lead. And, you know, you can't have two captains of a ship.
One's going to have to back down a little bit and let the other one take over.
Exactly.
Well, if Jeanette's writing the checks, then,
I'm sorry, I got the pen. So I cannot wait to see how what strengths you have. I know some of the strengths that you have, and you're also very caring. But also, it shows us, like Stephanie said, you know, it's like there are certain things that I found that I had to do. And I know of my whole life, I've had to work on certain things.
Mm-hmm.
And one of them is to be a little bit more of a, let's say, patient or a listener, because I like to have things done. Once I ask somebody to do something, I expect it to be done, not to have to ask them again, because I don't like being a nag. So, you know, even my son gave me a compliment the other day. He said, there was something I took to heart that you did when we were smaller or in the car. I would be impatient. If you guys are out there and you're impatient, someone's driving slow, the way I would not have it affect me is I would say to myself and to my kids, well, maybe it's a brand new driver. We don't want her to go faster than she can. Or you know, think of grandma. Grandma still has her driver's license. So, you know, I have had to learn how to be patient.
Mm-hmm.
And so I'm still working on it at my age.
I know what you mean about driving with your kids. Because
you're a driver by profession, so you probably have to be patient all the time. The people that come and cut you off, and then, so you're telling them, "Oh, it wasn't their fault," and the road rage. You're saying they must be in a hurry because
he's a great driver. I mean, I remember. I'll just make this really quick, but I remember he was running late for work, and he wanted, but he wanted to drive still. And he went into that auto mode to where it's like, okay, I just got to go to work.
Mm-hmm.
And he wasn't thinking about
other people surrounding him with other personalities.
But not like that, but more like he just kind of got into that mode. Like when you're learning how to drive, you're more cautious over things. Mm-hmm. But he just wanted to get from point A to point B. So he wasn't late to work, and I complimented him on it. I said, you know what, that's probably the best drive I've ever seen you did, you know. And he's a great driver. I don't know if it's because of me, but I'll take credit for it. So.
Well, the thing is, what Daniel said is you've made me be able to calm down in those situations. His fiancée was driving, and she was getting frustrated. And he turned to her, and it's funny how your kids will end up saying exactly what came out of mom's mouth. He turned to her and goes, it might be a young driver. You wouldn't want her to drive faster than her skills. And all of a sudden, his fiancée took a deep breath, and she goes, okay. Because, I mean, the one who gets frustrated is you. Why?
Mm-hmm.
You know?
So we're going to do my assessment next. So you're listening to Small Business Voice with Justin Dung and Jeanette Forney on Power Talk 1360 KFIV. And we are here with Stephanie Montalvo from John Maxwell's Live to Lead. And she is going to do my assessment next on Power Talk 1360 KFIV. Hammer and a nail.
Stacking them bales. Sysbro Innovations, connecting local businesses with local families. Display your services and products with our pay-as-you-go optimized website design program and boost your brand's online presence with our affordable social media marketing tools. To learn more, visit our website at sysbroinnovation.com. That's Sysbro, S-I-S-B-R-O, innovation.com.
Yeah, I think I'm gonna leave. Welcome back to the Small Business Voice with Justin Dung and Jeanette Forney on Power Talk 1360 KFIV. Reach out to us for more information about being a featured guest by texting 209-896-6500, or you can always email us at info@smallbusinessvoicemedia.com. Today we have Stephanie Montalvo here from John Maxwell's leadership group, Live to Lead. If you want to get a hold of Stephanie Montalvo, give her a call or text her at 209-986-3121. Or you can also contact her at stephanieleads2@gmail.com. And she did an assessment on me. I filled it out yesterday.
Mm-hmm.
And so I'm excited.
So none of us know?
None of us know. I didn't look at the results.
Oh, really?
No, I didn't. I just,
yeah, he left.
Okay, that means he's more patient than I am. Because I would have gone like, give it to me. Give it to me. And if it's not good, no one's telling.
He's definitely more patient than you, Jeanette.
Oh.
So
you definitely compliment each other. That's for sure.
Oh, that's good.
Yeah. I feel that.
Yeah,
you know, like
for sure.
We do compliment each other.
For sure. So I'm curious, Jeanette, if you were to take a guess at what you think his primary style is, what do you think he is?
See, I don't think he's a D. But I do definitely, as an influencer and things like this, I do believe he has some I in him. And
okay.
C, definitely. Mm-hmm. I think definitely a C as far as liking, and he has a great interest in other people.
Mm-hmm.
And then you have this thing of like, he's got the notepad and mm-hmm. the script, and I don't do scripts.
Okay.
Unless I memorize them, get paid a lot of money first.
Yeah.
But I think he definitely has some I, C, and then what is it?
There's I, S, and C.
Oh.
Because you said no D.
Okay, mm-hmm. yeah. So I, S, and maybe C.
Mm-hmm.
But
what do you think his primary is, if you were just take a stab at it?
It would probably be C, maybe.
Okay.
I don't know what these stammer, but I think of C as like comfort and wanting everybody mm-hmm. to be happy.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
And I
that
see
sounds...
that he's always, the way he was so concerned this morning that I had made it and he was going to call in the National Guard and calling my office and getting everybody worried.
Mm-hmm.
And the reason I think he's in this business, he was so interested in helping other businesses out there with their businesses and making sure everybody gets along.
Mm-hmm.
And
yeah.
But he is fun.
So I will tell you, he is an SC.
Oh, okay.
SC. So he does have C. However, his primary style is S.
So S is the one that's comforting, and C is the one that's everything by the book. Oh,
right.
No,
mm-hmm.
then it would be an S,
so,
the
yeah,
third one.
S is his primary. Mm-hmm. And no I or no D. So what's interesting is you're a DI. And he's an SC.
Oh.
So you complete each other, right? So you're disc together.
The
right?
yin
yeah.
and the
wow.
yang.
Yeah.
yeah. And I think that's probably why it works really well in terms of the show together. The two of you are very, complement each other mm-hmm. in your strengths.
Oh my goodness. Okay, mm-hmm. So his strengths, of course, we know what DI are. Just
mm-hmm. Would you like to hear what his strengths are?
Yes, yeah. I want to hear what his strengths are.
Like first off, too. Being an SC means you're a peacemaker.
Okay.
Is he a peacemaker, you think?
Yes, I think so. Yeah. I really, yeah, he cares about.
I don't like conflict.
Very agreeable. Is he agreeable?
Like other people.
He's very agreeable.
Okay.
Yeah.
And he usually expresses interest in other people.
That's what this whole show mm-hmm. is about. Yeah. It started because he had an interest in what other people. In other people.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yep. And he's very open.
Oh, very open.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yes.
Does that sound like you?
Yeah, it does. So, yeah. So I'm glad I did the test right.
So let's talk a little bit about what your weaknesses might be and tell me if I'm on the right track here.
Okay.
You're a little sensitive at times?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Aww.
Do you have, are you resistant to change?
I would say yeah.
Yeah, that's one of the things. And then you don't like confrontation.
No, I do not. In fact, not even between other people. Yeah. It bothers me.
I don't. Right. I don't think anyone likes confrontation. But I think it's how you handle deal it. With
yeah.
it.
Exactly. Mm-hmm. Yeah, and, a D, right?
A D says it's not me, it's you.
Well, I have two people that are close in my life that are, you know, that are friends mm-hmm. that. They don't get along mm-hmm. and I wish they could get past that mm-hmm. and, you know, just let the past be the past and,
right.
and go forward. But they probably have the same kind of personality too.
Yeah. That very well could be.
Yeah.
Yeah. If they could learn a little bit about each other and, you know, learn from each other, they might actually appreciate each other's strengths and what they bring to the table and appreciate, you know, we all have our limitations, right?
Yeah.
But, so for a couple other things, what motivates you? Are you motivated by tasks? Or are you motivated more by people?
I would say probably people.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's S.
Yeah. Because I like talking to people. Like I do a lot mm-hmm. of one-to-ones,
right.
which in Gold Star means you do like a lot of just getting together, right. talking, learning about the other person's business. And a lot of times I just kind of get lost in the conversation to where I forget to even talk about the sale that, you know, we're supposed to talk about. So it's, mm-hmm. you know, so like money's important, but money's not the first thing on my mind.
Right. Right.
Yeah. And seeing that's the whole thing with kind of like my personality, but I do like to do one-to-ones. I just can't seem to fit them into my busy schedule. Mm-hmm. But when I do one-to-one, the furthest thing from me is basically the sale. Because when I need sales, I need sales. I'm right. there for a purpose. I'm there to find out about them. And I kind of like stick to it mm-hmm. and have a great, my eye kicks in and I just want to have a great time and a good conversation. And I get the sale then anyway, because as I was walking out of an event we just did, people ran up to me asking me if I could give them a quote, mm-hmm. if they could have a job. So that's the whole thing. I don't worry about getting
this
the sale.
One just last Friday?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Wow. Yeah.
That's how I got my new employee. She heard me speak and she talked to her husband, who's a Gold Star member, uh-huh. and said, could you get me an interview?
Oh, wow.
And he texted me and he said, will you interview my wife for a job?
So
and yeah.
I have
and,
a question
And
really
she's
quick.
The perfect fit.
And that's the whole thing. She said, mm-hmm. now that I find out, she's a salesperson.
Right.
And they
she's
had,
what
put,
you've been need, you've
they had
needed.
Put her in a receptionist position. Mm. And she goes, I want to sail. So she was like that racehorse that mm-hmm. she just wanted to run. And then she saw what she's sees as right. her new boss. This one's going to make me money.
Right.
This one's going to get me the sales that and put me in a position where I can shine with my personality.
Mm-hmm.
So I am so thrilled I found out about her personality. And I would never push you, Justin, or set quotas on you. And I'm so glad that the two of us make up the perfect personality.
Yes, you do.
And
actually.
Notice how I said I was going to be quiet during this segment?
Yeah, it's okay.
This is like an Italian that sits on their hands. They can't talk.
But we know that your style is who you are.
So you're listening to the Small Business Voice with Justin Duggan and Jeanette Forney on Power Talk 1360 KFIV. We have Stephanie Montalvo in studio, and she works at the John Maxwell Leadership Group, Live to Lead. Give her a call or text her at 209-986-3121. Or you can also contact her at stephanieleads2@gmail.com. So there was a couple of things that was on my head. So the first thing is Jeanette gets a lot of phone calls about the show, and mm-hmm. I don't.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm the one that started the show. Jeanette's my third co-host, but people seem more comfortable calling her or calling her office.
Mm-hmm.
and they don't call me. Is that, does that kind of work in this kind of dynamic? Is that, does that surprise
well,
you?
Well, no, it doesn't surprise me at no? all.
Okay.
Yeah, because she is so outgoing,
yeah.
right? She's very direct, and I think that's probably a little bit of an attraction for people.
Uh-huh. Well, if they want answers, too.
Exactly.
If, yeah. they, if they want a friend, that mm-hmm. would be Justin, but mm-hmm. when they're calling me, they have very specifics of,
right.
can you, like I've said before, I've had business people, they're very successful business people. They'll walk into my office and say, I want to see Jeanette, and sit down and go, Jeanette, I have this new business venture. Mm-hmm. What do you think?
Right.
And they know that I'm like, going, oh, that sounds great. I'm going, no, you have too much on your plate. Just pass this one over. And they mm-hmm. go, you know what? Everybody's been telling me that maybe I should do it in such a great deal. But he goes, I figured I'd come to you. Because mm-hmm. again, I'm direct.
Right.
I'm going to tell them.
You're going to tell it like it is.
Exactly.
Yeah.
And in business, you need someone like that.
Absolutely.
Sometimes.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So another one I wanted to ask you too is you do this for couples, like people in relationships.
Right. Mm-hmm.
And you know, I wish I would have known you probably four or five years ago because, you know, I was with a girlfriend and mm-hmm. the first 5 months were great. Honeymoon period, mm-hmm. you know, the last 9 months, we were down each other's throats. We were mm-hmm. fighting all the time. There's a lot of, no trust in the relationship, I guess, mm-hmm. the best way of putting it.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of insecurity. I always wanted to go see a therapist.
Mm-hmm.
And she would tell me, it was like, well, you're the one who needs to see the therapist, not me. So, you know, so I was getting
maybe
a roadblock there.
Are you, you know what, that's the whole thing. Your personality can also attract
right.
the wrong, are you putting out the wrong attraction?
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, it's like they sometimes women are always picking the same type of
yeah.
guy.
Yeah.
Well,
type
and
of
it
guy.
Seems like
so,
I do the same thing. I
yeah.
pick the same kind of woman.
Right, exactly.
You know, that's very, I would, now I'm going to get myself in trouble, but like very dominant mm-hmm. minded, you mm-hmm. know, because I'm not, I'm not a D.
Right,
you know?
You're a peacemaker.
I'm a peacemaker, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
But I don't want to, I'm not one of those people that want to fight in a relationship. I just want to be.
You don't like confrontation.
I don't, no. And I want somebody that's going to be like a team, you know.
Right,
like
partner.
A partner.
But that might
thank
not be
you.
Exciting mm-hmm. enough for you. If you know, because then you end up in the friend zone. So, I mean, that is a difficult one. But I'm sure that Stephanie will be able to talk to you about
say, well,
that.
That's what
the
makes
debrief.
The report so important. It's a 30-page report.
And, oh, wow.
So what I, like I said, you know, make it as simple to understand as possible. I spend 30 minutes with you, go through it. We go through the key parts of it. We talk about the communication do's and don'ts. We also talk about, you know, what some of your fears are, because that comes out in the report as well.
Oh, I got a lot of fears.
Well, it says here that one of your fears, let's see what one of your fears are. Your biggest fear is loss of security or being criticized. Does that sound right?
Yeah, I would say so. Yeah,
lose everything.
I get
works,
kind of,
yeah.
Yeah. Well, I've lost everything before in a divorce, so that really sucks.
Yeah, that's not good.
So what?
Yeah.
So the thing is, I hired you because mm-hmm. of my office,
right?
And I wanted the office because cohesive. But as a business owner, I wanted to make sure how I could take, advantage, but of the skills
yes,
of
absolutely.
My staff
right.
and learn how to communicate with. Them
bringing
better.
Out the best in
what
your people.
What other kind of tests? Because you said you have one for,
right.
I know you did one for my daughter for
mm-hmm.
like best careers.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
And then my son, mm-hmm. I guess he's a procrastinator. He hasn't taken his yet, 18 years old.
So he might be a high I. Is he really outgoing?
No.
Okay.
No, video games locked in his room.
I tend to be the people
room.
that don't do it when they're supposed to.
Mm.
That's how I know they're an
I think
I
that's
usually.
18. But
yeah.
I don't know. He might. Okay. I mean, look, my daughter was opposite of what I thought she was.
So you're listening to Small Business Voice with Justin Duncan and Jeanette Forney on Power Talk 1360 KFIV. And we are here with Stephanie Montalvo, and she works at the John Maxwell Leadership Group, Live to Lead. If you want to get a hold of Stephanie Montalvo, give her a call or text her at 209-986-3121. Or you can also contact her at stephanieleads2@gmail.com. Reach out to us for more information about our featured guest by texting 209-896-6500. Or you can always email us at info@smallbusinessvoicemedia.com. Stay with us on Power Talk 1360 KFIV.
Hey, y'all, what's going on? Been waiting on this all day long.
This business tip is brought to you by Cispro Innovation. I'm Catherine Ramos, and today we're talking about local networking. Connect with other local businesses, attend community events, and join local business associations like Gold Star Referral Clubs and the Modesto Chamber of Commerce. This helps to establish your business within the community. and create useful partnerships that will help your company gain valuable referrals. CISPRO Innovation, where we help local businesses connect with local families. For more information on this tip, check out our blog at CISPROinnovation.com. That's CISPRO, S-I-S-B-R-O, Innovation.com.
Welcome back to the Small Business Voice with Justin Nugent and Jeanette Forney on Power Talk 1360 KFIV. Reach out to us on any of our featured guests by texting 209-896-6500, or you can always email us at info@smallbusinessvoicemedia.com. You can always pull up our past shows on the iHeart app. Just search and follow the Small Business Voice. Like and follow us on Facebook, Instagram, X, TikTok, and YouTube. Stephanie Montalvo is still here with us. This has like been a conversation that we just like, we're finding out more and more, and it's like an hour show is not gonna do justice. But really quick, Community Corner is proudly sponsored by Lightspeed Graphics, a creative media agency specializing in video and animation. To get in touch with owner Kurt Gonzalez, simply text him at 209-617-2606 or visit his website at lightspeedgraphics.com. No emotion from Kurt, but I thought I did pretty good on that one. So, okay, there we go. That probably, I need some, like, you know, interaction. Mm-hmm. So
we need
probably
to find out his personality type. So that
you will. Yeah. You okay. will soon.
What other kind of things do you offer as far as personalities?
So there's several different types of assessments. You guys took the Maxwell DISC assessment, the main assessment, but we offer an entrepreneurial report. So for business owners and leaders specific to them. Sales profile reports, sales leader reports. And with that, then there's workshops to follow to help bring out some of where there's, you know, limitations, and also to bring out their strengths. Of course, the one like your daughter did, the career report. And then we have an impact and benchmarking report for like interviews. We have specific ones for interview candidates. And then lastly, we have the group report, which what that is we take all of the information we received, like on Jeanette's team, and we put it all together, and then out comes a report that details the whole entire team's strengths and weaknesses and limitations and how they communicate. And so then what I'm doing with that is we're taking that, and we have a 3-hour staff meeting scheduled in a couple weeks. We're doing a leadership sales game to help increase their sales influence. And then we're also doing a 17 laws teamwork workshop in a couple of weeks as well. So what we've done is we take the information that we receive from the report, where we need to focus, like with her team, it's sales influence. They need some sales training. So that's what we're going to do. And so that's how beneficial it is. Once you get that group report, it gives you a snapshot of what your team needs, where your strengths are and where your limitations are.
And my new employee starts on the 13th. Going to be like this next perfect coming timing. Week. Mm-hmm. And so that will also help incorporate her to the personalities team. Yep. of the rest of the team. Because that's what I need. I need a really good team so that I don't like to micromanage, and I want to be able to get run my business. As a business owner, you need to be able to do that.
In order to be successful, you have to have the right team in place. Mm-hmm.
I agree.
And bring out, you know, create an environment to bring out their strengths, right?
So,
and that's what she's doing.
So was this more of a personal assessment on me, or is this more of a business assessment?
This is more of a personal assessment.
Okay.
If you wanted one more specific to like business, we would find the one that works best for you.
Okay.
You're not really in sales, so I wouldn't say sales.
Well, that's not true.
Okay. Could you do that? You also do Legal Shield, right?
Yeah, I do. Yeah.
Yeah. So maybe that would be a good
one. But is that something that, see, you're so good at this and talking to people because that is a passion.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And then sales, you probably struggle a bit.
I do.
Yeah, mm-hmm. exactly. Yeah.
That might be a good one for you to take.
Okay.
Just to see kind of where your opportunities are there.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Yeah, then you and I need to exchange some. Well, you got my card already.
For sure.
Everybody needs Stephanie. So Stephanie, what's your phone number again?
It's 209-986-3121.
Oh, all right.
Very easy. Call her anytime.
Anytime.
Anytime. Wow. So, you can probably email Stephanie at any time at stephanieleads2@gmail.com.
Yes.
So, and then she'd get back to you promptly.
Absolutely. That is a cell phone, correct? So they could text you.
Yeah. Text me at that number also.
Help. I need your help. And just the phone number and you'll get out to. And you know what? It's not that expensive. I do want to say that the not only like the test assessment and then the follow-up, the debriefing and everything else is under $100. Mm-hmm. I mean, Yeah. I mean, and it helped me so much to have that understanding. Mm-hmm. And especially before, if I would have hired one more customer service person, you know, it's like the for sale sign goes up on the door.
Yeah. And then when I try to hire people, I do a terrible, terrible job at it. And
really?
Yeah. I have like, they maybe last like a week. You know?
I could help you with that.
Okay.
Yeah. I help with that too.
And I think so. Our intern's not here today. Mm-hmm. I think my leadership skills are probably need to be,
because
an
you
area
don't want
of opportunity.
Yeah.
Yeah. An area for development.
Yeah. Oh, no,
look at you being so, S with an area. It's called an area of opportunity.
Well, and I would say like one of my strengths is I don't take anything personal. Like when it comes to business,
right.
It's, you know, if somebody's mad or upset, I don't take that as a personal, you know, I just kind of,
it's business.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. I just listen. So I don't get emotional over things like that.
Mm-hmm.
But I know there's a lot of things I need to work on, you know.
Yeah. But that's also your thing of not wanting a conflict. If you were to get emotional about it, then there would be a conflict.
Right.
So a defense mechanism is, I'm not going to take it personally.
No confrontation.
Yeah.
Okay. Well,
I mean, that could be another way of looking at it.
Yeah.
I don't like confrontation either, but if somebody comes with me, I don't want the confrontation, so I'm going to shut you down in 2 minutes.
Yeah.
And you'll think twice before you come at me again.
But if I get backed into a corner, you know, if I feel like I'm backed into a corner, I will come out at you. Mm-hmm. And that's not really my personality type.
Right. But if you need to.
If I need to, I will. Yeah.
Right.
Especially if kids are involved.
Yeah. You know what? I wasn't really like that with my kids. You know, I think I was pretty easy. You know what? We should bring my kids in here one of these times and they can really
tell.
Yeah.
Spill the
beans.
No, that's old school. Spill the tea in these days.
Let's keep up with the tea.
You know, because I'm sure there's things as a father that I did really well. Mm-hmm. And then there's things as a father I probably weren't too good on, you know, like I wasn't really a good rule maker, you know, like we, you know, like, okay, bedtime's at 10. It's like, well, can we watch this show?
I don't think that's really that bad. I don't believe so much in, because I'm not the ducks in a row. Mm-hmm. But I think if you instill in your children the right morals and all of those things, you shouldn't have to be strict and follow by the rules, because they know them, because they have them inside their heart.
They're my son's 24. I'm very proud of my son. He went to Vegas together this last weekend, so that was a lot of fun.
Mm-hmm.
He took me out to breakfast, which I found out my breakfast was like $100, but you know, he just, you know, paid for it. So don't
what
worry
did
about
you
it.
Have?
I was going to say, what kind of breakfast did you have?
Yeah. They had this crippled egg sauce that was
steak in there somewhere.
Awesome. Yeah. Well, it's Vegas. Like everything's just so,
but food anyway, there is good.
Yeah. Food. It was delicious. This was a kid I worried about. Mm-hmm. And he is just, ever since he became an adult, 21 years old, he moved out and he makes just as much money as I do per hour.
Nice.
Yeah. And he lives in San Francisco. You know, I mean, he's living his dream.
So the right thing. The whole point of a parent is to raise children that do not need you any longer.
Exactly.
And that
they
is
don't.
Actually the hardest thing in the world, that they don't need you anymore. I mean, they still need the hug.
Right.
And, you know, my home would, because I have
but
seven
they're not
children.
Dependent on you.
Yeah. Could you imagine if I had seven needy kids? Oh, my God.
Yeah.
I couldn't even run a business. But that's all. It sounds like you did absolutely the right things.
Yeah, well,
exactly.
Okay,
but they're not in jail.
They're not in jail.
There we
but
go.
we got to have you come back on again, because I got like a ton of questions. we're just out of time.
I love it.
And see, everybody out there, I know that people are curious, and I have found it in business to help so much, especially when I found out that I have the right choice for a business manager. Mm-hmm. And that's why I can turn those things over to her and know that she's going to handle them the correct way.
Mm-hmm.
While I, you know, I'm able to run the business, and they have the whole thing of that. They actually said, we're so glad that you're our leader, because you take care of this tough stuff and we're going to have a job, because I'm not going to quit.
So,
that's the whole thing.
Right.
All right. So, Stephanie, we're going to have you back on soon.
Okay.
So, anyway, if you want to get in a hold of Stephanie Montalvo, give her a call at 209-986-3121. Or you can also contact her at StephanieLeads2@gmail.com. I like your sweater, by the way.
Oh, thank you.
Yeah, I wanted to say that also. So just want to thank our audience for tuning in each week. We look forward to having you back next week. Our heartfelt shout out to our dedicated producer, Mike Murray, and the general manager of KCBP, Jim Costello. Actually, Gennaro Frida is stepping for him today. So thank you, Gennaro, for doing that. We also appreciate the hard work of our intern, Matt Boucher. Special thanks to Kurt Gonzalez from Lightspeed Graphics, Video, and Animation for capturing our inspiring guests and their stories. If you're seeking assistance with digital marketing, don't hesitate to reach out to Kurt at 209-617-2606 or via email at kurt@lightspeedgraphics.com. Thank you, Jeanette Forney, for joining me today and your support on the Small Business Voice. Remember to call her office at 209-667-2222 or you can email her at JeanetteForney@allstate.com. Remember to join us every Saturday from 11 a.m. to noon as we dive into the minds of local business owners with even more insightful discussions. And a special thanks to our guest today, Stephanie Montalvo, for sharing her experience with us. Now, let's take care of business.